guys and gals, how's it going? Welcome back to our 7 Days to Die season 2. So here we are. I do have some bad news for you guys, and I'm really sorry. I mean, it's not totally bad news. I had to cancel the the 7 Days to Die server. I had to cancel my subscriptions to Cage and Game Edge because I can't afford it right now, and it really hurts. I've been so upset today. I've cried so much today having to, you know, cancel the server, because that's the server that me and Charisma do our multiplayer on. But I'm sorry, if you don't have the money, you don't have the money. I broke out in tears today when I had to cancel my gym membership. I'm pretty much cried out, I think, but it's fine. You know, shit happens. You know, my husband offered to pay this credit card off, and that's what I want y'all to understand, okay? My family is not in debt, so don't feel sorry for us like that in any way, shape, or form, okay? The family is fine. This is just a personal debt that I have, you know, and it wouldn't have been a problem if I had been getting hours at my job, and I didn't choose to put my husband's gifts on the credit card, like, for Christmas. I went ahead, I bought his gifts on the credit card, and, you know, because I assumed I would get some hours over the holidays, and I really didn't, even though I volunteered, you know, to work any holidays that she needed me, it didn't happen. You know, I didn't get the hours, so I put that stuff on the credit card thinking, you know, it's the holiday season, I would get more hours, and I didn't get more hours, so I'm pretty broke. I don't have the money to pay off the credit card. So whatever. I had to cancel that. Really, really, really bums me out. My husband has offered to pay it off. He offered to pay the card off last month or something, and I told him, no, it's okay. I'm like, I'm paying a little bit on it at a time. I'll get it paid off. No worries. Don't worry about it. And I couldn't let him pay it off, guys. That's like him buying his own Christmas gifts if I were to let him pay that off. And it's not really that high, you know? It's not that high. And I actually had to re-record this because I did end up crying initially in the other video. So I'm like, you know what? I had to re-record it. So, you know, I was just really upset. You know, I can't believe I even, when I went to the gym, I don't know why I broke down, but I broke down when I was talking to them, telling them I had to cancel the gym membership. You know, the guy gave me a hug before I left. They offered to put the membership on hold, and which was, like, totally sweet of them, but I was like, you know what, they've already put it on hold for me once before, and I just, you know. I told him no. I'm like, I can't have you do that for me again. I'm like, they've already put it on hold for me once before, because they will do 3-month holds, you know, for people who want to keep the membership and are having problems. But I just, you know, I'm not a charity case. I don't want them to do that. You know, I'm like, you know, if and when I get more hours at work or whatever, then maybe I can renew the membership or something. So I told him, don't worry about it, it's fine. And, you know, the guy, you know, I was just ready to leave. You know, he's like, don't cry, it's okay, you know, things will get better. And I'm like, you know what, it's fine, you know. And he told me, yeah, you can't let you leave unless you smile first, and he gave me a hug, so that was totally cool. And I am an emotional person, just so you guys know that. You guys don't know anything about me. I mean, I know maybe you feel like you do a little bit, but you really don't. I am a rather emotional person. And sadly, you know, my 13-year-old kind of takes over. You know, it's kind of like me. He's very, very sensitive and very emotional as well. And I can't believe my axe is dead. So we have to go make another one. But yeah, we're just, the two of us are very, very emotional people, sadly. So, and I've had my forges running. And there was a screamer over here. But yes, I was recording earlier and I actually was pretty upset. So it's kind of good that I stopped it. And because, I don't know, I really like doing this. I can't believe they broke it. They're going to break out all my ladders, and eventually I'm not going to have a way to get up there. No, Screamer. Don't do it. I'm going to make 5. I didn't want metal ladders, but oh well. I'll deal with metal ladders, I suppose. No, let's not do metal. Oh, I did it wrong. See, I'm all derpy today. Extra derpy. Alright, yeah, there's a screamer over here. I heard her. But, I don't know. I'm an emotional girl. What did we come over here for? I kind of forgot. Yeah, it's kind of hard to be all concentrated. Oh, you know what? I forgot they broke this shit out. Huh. Oh, yeah, we came to make ourselves another... Uh-oh. Let's go down here before she sees me. Go down here. Oh, my goodness. I hope they don't end up in here. I need some forged iron. I'm not going to turn that on, though. I already have her out there. I'll just use what I had in here. Please tell me she didn't just call in people to come down my ladder. That would be totally screwed up. Very, very screwed up. But yeah, I don't know. I mean, I really like YouTube, guys. You don't understand. YouTube is, like, really good for me. I don't honestly have a lot of friends outside, you know, in the real world. Not real life friends. And that's just because I have some serious trust issues, honestly. I either trust people too easily, or I don't trust them enough, you know, and you know, friendships are hard for me, especially female friendships, because, you know, as I was growing up, you know, my mother gave me up for adoption when I was like 8 years old. The family that adopted me actually abused me, so it's like I went from, you know, one family to another, you know. It was like I was rejected by both of the women in my life. So for me to connect with women is, you know, it's a struggle. I mean, I do feel like I'm a people person. I love getting to know new people. I love making new friends. You know, I love all that, but it is hard to actually connect for me. So it's, you know, I don't know. It's kind of sad, really. But I like YouTube because I can connect with people without, you know, for the most part, without the fear of, you know, being hurt. I get, if that makes sense to you guys. I don't know. Maybe that won't make sense to you guys. Yeah, so I don't know. It's rough sometimes. You know, I mean... I was on Game Edge's channel today watching his stream, and you know, someone mentioned something about getting high or whatever, and you know, it's like, you know, I've never done drugs. I've never done that ever a day in my life. And you know, some of the shit I went through, you know, the family that adopted me, they abused me physically, mentally, emotionally, sexually, and I could have turned to drugs. A lot of people who, you know, go through that kind of shit, they do turn to drugs, and I chose not to do that. You know, I prefer to talk about my problems. You know, I would rather talk to a stranger about my problems then just keep it bottled up inside. I feel bad for people who cannot talk about their problems. I really do feel bad for them because it really does help. Now, I did try to go see a counselor once, and that just, it sucked. You know, it just totally sucked because the guy fell asleep on me. So I actually refuse to go see doctors now about anything that's bothering me, like psychologists and stuff, because I'm like, how can you fall asleep when your patient is talking to you? It's just totally uncool. And this was when I was in the military. This was like a military chaplain or something. So, oh, hurry up, forged iron. Because I wanted to make another pickaxe too. But, I don't know. Whatever. I don't know. I feel like I'm a little emotional today, guys. Because partially, I don't know who all was there for the stream. I know there was a few people that came in for the stream on Wednesday. We did have trolls that night. And I don't do well with trolls. Sadly, that's something I have a hard time with. I don't know. I'm a very sensitive person, so I take things to heart. And I don't know, I think that kind of brought me down. So it's probably enhanced my emotions about this having to cancel all these subscriptions and all that crap. It's probably just enhanced all that, quite honestly. And I think that's partially why I'm so upset today. But I'm doing better. And like, I figured I'd play for you guys, and you know, that should make me feel somewhat better. Just because I like playing games, for one thing. And these things take forever to make. Why I was trying to recompose myself, because like I said, I did start recording a video for you guys, but oh my gosh, I was like a big ass crybaby in that video. So yeah, I had to I just played through all of day 27 without you guys. I'm so sorry. Alright, do we have, oh, I have cobblestone, right? Because we need to repair this stuff before we leave. But yes, I was getting the diner ready, just so you guys know. I was over there getting that ready for Horde Night. I thought I still had some blocks, because I need to put those blocks in there. I don't have them with me, though. Alright, I do have this axe. I'm going to combine these on the workbench. And actually, I wanted to make another pickaxe too and combine those. Awesome. Alright, so let's just make a mad dash for it. Hopefully the screamer doesn't see me, because this is all broken out up here. These fools came in here. It was very, very sad they did. But yeah, I feel horrible that I had to cancel my subscriptions. Because I subscribe to Game Edge on Patreon. And I subscribe to Cage on Twitch. And I did have to cancel those subscriptions temporarily too. I've canceled my Battlefield 4 server. I've canceled a lot of stuff. I just, you know, I can't do it right now. And it just makes me feel horrible. And I want you guys to know how much I do appreciate you, you know, purchasing games for me. It's totally sweet of you, because this is my livelihood right now. I just feel bad because I don't like relying on other people to do that stuff. And I know I've had people mention, why don't I set up donations or something. I don't know. I can't bring myself to feel okay with doing that. I actually feel bad sometimes about even taking the games. And I know you guys are just doing it because you like to watch the channel, and you know, you appreciate me doing the videos for you guys and everything. And that's totally cool. I don't know how I can explain to you how much I appreciate it. I hope you guys can just tell, or you can hear it in my voice, how much I appreciate you guys providing the games and stuff. And I'm sure the other subscribers appreciate it too, because you know, it's more stuff for them to watch too. And I don't have any polls here. I don't have any polls. We need to make some polls. I wonder how many I need to make. Let's make some freaking poles. Cobblestone poles, please. We want these, right? Yeah. I'm only going to make 25. I don't know how many I need. Just to fill in these freaking holes. They must have been beating on this while I was over there working on the stuff on the other side over at the... whatever you want to call it. I'll fix it later. Let's go over here and see if we can't put up some more of these silly things over here. I can't believe it's almost Horde Night. Oh my gosh, guys. Horde Night is coming. It's coming for real. But yeah, I don't know. I feel bad. I don't know. I'm just not myself today. Not at all. Not at all. I hate that I'm an emotional person, but at the same time, it's what makes me who I am. You know, and being abused and stuff growing up, I mean, I don't even look at that as a bad thing, guys. I really don't. I mean, look what kind of person I've turned out to be considering what I've been through, you know? I feel like I'm an amazing person for what I've been through. And no one can tell me otherwise. They just can't. I'm very proud of the person I've become. And it's because of my life experiences. So, it's totally okay. I mean, what does bother me, though, is because there are people out there. I think I started to tell you guys that, you know, people were talking about, you know, not necessarily getting high. I think I used the wrong high for whatever reason. I don't know why I do that sometimes. When I was talking about, oh yeah, it was something Game Edge did in his game, and I was like, oh yeah, you say hi to the hunters by, you know, coming at them with guns, and he's like, yeah, is there any other way? And I used the word H-I-G-H instead of H-I, and that brought people up to think about, you know, getting high or whatever, and I was like, I have never been high a day in my life, and I know there are people out there in the world who don't handle things as well as others. And even though I was sexually abused, physically abused, emotionally abused growing up as a kid, I never once turned to drugs and alcohol to deal with that stuff. I did not. I always, you know, I just talk to people. It's just better to talk about it than let it eat you up inside. And I feel bad for people who aren't willing to talk about what's going on in their lives and just deal with it. That's why I'd love to hear other people's stories. I bet some of you have had, you know, pretty, you know, rough lives too. And, you know, share that with us in the community, man. It just shows how strong you are. You know, look where I'm at today. Considering what I went through, look how strong I am. Look where I'm at today in my life. Like, my kids, I would never hit my kids. You know, there's people that go through that are abused growing up, and they end up abusing their children. And I'm like, I cannot understand why people use that as a reason for abusing their own children. You know, they're like, oh, well, that's how I was raised. You know, so that's, you know, the only way I know how to be. I guess my mentality is a lot different than people like that, because, you know, me being abused and hit, you know, physically abused growing up, I'm like, I cannot hit my children. You know, I would never put my children through that. I'm like, I guess I don't understand people's mentality on that. That, oh, well, and they're not, and I know these people don't say it's okay that they're that way, but I don't understand how you can even think that way. Oh, that's how I was raised. No, that's what makes you think, oh, it's not okay. Oh, I've been through that. I don't want to put my kids through that. I'm like, what the heck is wrong with people to think it's okay because you were raised that way, that it's okay to hit your children? I mean, I don't even believe in that, like, for punishing children, like when they do something wrong. to teach them that hitting them is the way to solve the problem. Okay, well, you did this. This was wrong, so I'm going to spank you. And I'm not judging people. Y'all do what you want to do to make your children behave. But it's, for me, it's like saying that, you know, this is how we handle things if we don't like what you've done. We handle it with violence. You know, we're going to whoop you because, you know, you did something wrong. Maybe part of my reason for not being able to, you know, hit my kids has to do with being abused growing up. I don't know. I just, you know, it's not something I can do. Do I not have more metal? Because I need some more, what do I need? Oh, yeah, more barbed wire. But yes, this is just a venting day. I hope you guys are okay with that. I mean, if you're not, I apologize. You can just skip the video altogether if you want. You know, but we all have those days where we just want to vent and, you know. I mean, like, if I had real life friends to talk to, that would be super great. But I don't. I just don't have people I can go and talk to. I don't know. I'd rather share it with strangers, as weird as that may seem. Alright, let's make some more iron. Can we make 500, please? Are we allowed to have that? Nope, I guess not. Alright, we'll take 291. That's totally cool. Whatever. Let's put some of this in here. I guess we could get some from here, huh? Yeah, let's get some from here, too. But yeah, I appreciate y'all being here. And honestly, I want you guys to share your stories. I'm kind of pouring my guts out to you just because I've had a bad couple of days. And I mean, you wouldn't know it in the stream. I honestly think the stream is what really set me off here. It just sent me over the edge a little bit. So let's see. What do we make? 291. So go with what? No, I don't want to do that. But yeah, I mean, I don't know. Can any of you relate to me? Have any of you ever, were any of you abused growing up? And you, how do you think you turned out considering? I think I turned out great, you know? And though I don't have a lot of, did I say forged iron? I didn't want to do that many forged iron. I wanted to do this iron. Yeah, please and thank you. I'm glad I caught that. That would have been horrible. But yeah, I don't know, guys. Share your story with me. You know what I'm saying? Can you guys relate at all? Like the credit card thing, that, I don't think that, I don't, I feel like that's, I don't know. It's just weird how money can set you off. But like I said, I feel like it was a combination of the money and, yeah, the money situation, having to cancel all that stuff, and the trolls coming in last night. So that's just a sign. Like when the trolls come in like that, guys, it just throws off my whole demeanor, if that's even the right thing. Yeah, I can go from being very happy to all of a sudden I don't know what else to say. I'm just down, and you know, I don't want to be that way when I stream. That's why I really need to have regulars when I'm streaming, so that I can mod people that will not tolerate that kind of shit. You know, I had to leave the game multiple times to ban people from the actual, to actually ban people from the server, because I was getting pretty upset. I mean, it was a good thing I wasn't doing a super long stream anyway, so it was fine. Alright, come on, give me the rest of this. Sorry guys, I'm a little off my game because I've been so upset today. Pretty upset. Yeah, I tried to hide it pretty good last night, that I was upset people were being assholes in the stream. But it's to be expected, I guess. You know, it can't always have a good stream. Like Game Edge, he never has problems like that when in his stream. I don't think I've ever seen people just come in and just be total absolute assholes. Of course, I don't know that I've caught every one of his streams either, because he does tend to stream late sometimes. And during the week, I'm typically, you know, we typically try to go to bed by like 10:30 or 11 during the week, because got to get up early. But, yeah, I'm like, I wish I could have a bunch of good people in my stream like he does. I do have a lot of good people. I don't want y'all to think, I'm not saying you aren't good, but I need more regulars, people that it can be there more regular. I mean, if I could come up with a regular stream schedule, it would probably help, and people probably could do that. But with my availability at my job is pretty much Tuesday through Saturday. Like, Tuesday through Friday, I'm available to close, but I'm very rarely scheduled Tuesday through Thursday, usually just Friday and Saturday, and then Saturday is the only day I work day shift, and then Sundays and Mondays I'm just off. You know, for me, that's my weekend, so that's why I do that way. Alright, let's go see if we can't repair these now. And I turn this on, the screamers are going to be back. Maybe she won't be. Maybe they left. That would be super cool. Alright, so this one needs repaired. We will repair these and then we'll go finish getting ready for Horde Night. I hope a Horde Night's not going to be too horrible, quite honestly. Boop. Alright, and then there's something else broken out over here. Yeah, this is annoying. I guess they can spawn in here. Right, guys? Are they able to spawn in here because of, because they don't have player-made blocks laid in here? Because they didn't break out any of the poles out there, I don't think. So I feel like they spawned in here. So yeah, I'm going to have to do something about that. I'm going to have to get player-made blocks laid down outside this thing. Because it was Bob. Bob was in here. Yeah. When I came over here earlier. Yeah, I basically had to go through a whole entire day without you guys. That's how upset I was. So I started to record and I just, yeah, shut it down. I'm like, I can't do it. I can't do it. Super duper. Yeah, I apologize. Oh, there is a block out here. Who knew? I didn't know that was out. I did not see that. Actually, I think I did see that because I mentioned that I don't have a ladder there. So maybe I did see that and I just forgot that I saw that. I wanted to put it out of my mind. Alright, let's go take care of that. Let's go take care of that broken block. I did bring those too, right? I did. Good. Very, very good. Just making sure I did bring those. Oh, I need another hammer too. Because my hammer's about had it. My hammer's seen better days. Alright, let's clear this guy out of here. So yeah, maybe they're not spawning in here, but I still want to get blocks laid down in there. That's why we can't do Horde Night here. We can't do it here. Because it's not ready. It is super not ready. Super duper. Alright, so do I keep you guys here until, like... Wow, look at all this crap they be breaking out. These zombies are super bad. Super bad! And they definitely keep breaking this house out. And they're gonna take it down eventually, I suppose. Alright, so that's good. It's mostly good. Need them to quit breaking out my ladders. I may have to put better ladders up there. Alright, they left that open for me. I was thinking they broke that. But they didn't. Uh-oh. Where's she at? Oh, there she is. Hey, you little wench. Yeah, you're super bad calling in zombies. We don't have time for zombies. We gotta get ready for Horde Night, girlfriend. Yeah, Brutus. Stay down, bro beans. Stop bothering me. Oh yeah, and for those who weren't here for the stream on Wednesday night, just know that we are doing our drawing. It was mentioned in that stream, but I will announce it here too. If you want to participate in the next drawing, which I will be drawing the winner on Saturday, just leave a comment in this video saying, I love minions! Just say you love minions, even if you don't love minions. If you would like to be considered for the Steam card giveaway, just comment in this video saying that you love minions. And I will enter your name in the drawing. Now, those of you who were in the stream on Wednesday, you do not need to put that comment there because I've already did a... I've already done tickets for you guys. And what we'll do is I'll probably just have my youngest go ahead and he can draw the name Saturday, because I think what we're going to do is Saturday, I don't know, it'll be either early afternoon, late afternoon, I don't know, it'll be sometime in the afternoon and the evening we will be streaming Resident Evil 7, thanks to Mrs. Tweety. That we will stream that live, and I am going to try and just stream that live all the time. I'm not trying to stream that or record that, so yeah, look, they're tearing this place up, fools. But yes, if you want to participate, if you would like to have a $25 Steam card, and yes guys, I did buy this, and even though I did have to cancel the other things in order, you know, to do this, that's fine. Just know, I may not do the giveaways 4 weeks in a row, but I will still do 4 giveaways. So we did one last week, Headshot Dynamite won that one. We're doing the one this week. Now, I might have to wait a week before I can do the next one. I'm not sure yet. We'll see. I may not have to wait. I'll have to see what my paycheck's like. Because I did cancel all this other stuff, so none of this stuff is going on my credit card. Sadly, with the Amazon gift card that I gave to Headshot Dynamite, for some reason, my bank would not approve me actually buying that with my debit card, even though I had $90 in that account. I don't know if it's an Amazon thing, if they just don't trust that or what, but I had to end up putting his $25 gift card on my credit card again. So, yeah, and I can't put anything else on my credit card. So I have to figure out why the bank did not want to let me put that on there. Oh, I was like, where's my barbed wire? It didn't make any more yet. Let's make 33 more of those, sure. We don't really need 33, but whatever. We just need to fill these in. But yes, please participate in this giveaway by responding to this video. And like I said, why is there a block missing there? The winner will be announced on Saturday. I mean, if I decide I'm not doing a stream, I will announce it in the Subnautica video. Well, actually, I can't say that because yeah, the Subnautica video, I'll be working on that on Friday, so, yeah, whatever. We'll do a stream Saturday. It should be fine. If for some reason we don't, I can put it in the comments section, or I'll just post a little, whatever you want to call that, I'll do a thumbnail and just post it up there with the winner's name or something if I have to. So either way, we will announce the winner on Saturday, whether it's in a live stream. It should be in a live stream. There shouldn't be any reason why I can't, because this week I'm only working. I work Friday. Yeah, our schedules go from Friday to Thursday, but this week I'm working Friday and Tuesday. So Saturday should definitely be a stream day. Sure. And if we decide to do streams where I'm playing with the subscribers, like on 7 Days to Die or something, just keep in mind it's not going to be an official server. It's just going to be us playing on a multiplayer, which would be local to me. So I don't know how well that would work for you guys at all, but you know, we'll pay for that server whenever I can get the money to pay for it again. And it's all right. Our world was kind of freaking jacked up anyway, as I'm sure the ladies would tell you. I don't think I can put another block here, right? Will it let me put one there? I don't think it will. Let's turn it around. Turn her around. Oh, you did let me lay that there. Or you didn't. No, you didn't. I lied. It's not going to let me lay that there. Alright. Whatever. Alright, so I hope we're mostly ready. You know what I need to do? I need to go get some freaking air... some, stuff for... I need freaking feathers. I don't know if I want to keep you guys here for feather collecting, because I don't think I have much ammo. Let's go up here and see what we have up here. Because, yeah, the Horde Knight is coming. The Horde Knight is coming soon. Actually, maybe we'll do Horde Knight Saturday too or something. That would be cool. We could do Horde Knight and some Resident Evil. That could definitely happen. Oh, look, I made these extra spikes and I didn't even need them. But that's okay, I suppose. I suppose that's alright. Seeing if we have any arrows in here. Arrows. Do you have any arrows? I don't think so. Arrows! Yeah, I haven't been putting my weapons together either. What a dummy. We do have some feathers. We could put these together. Right? Because I have those. Let's see. We're going to do the iron crossbow bolts, though. Yeah, let's do those. Because I do have like 149 of those over at the other base. Put those feathers back. I don't know. We might have to take this over there. I don't even know if I have a shotgun over there for Horde Knight. I don't know. I don't know, guys. I don't know. Horde Knight might suck, to be honest with you. It might not be very, very good. It might be very, very sad, Horde Knight. It might be very horrible. You might die miserable deaths. I guess I can leave these over here. Since, we were doing our Horde Knight here. So we'll leave this and this here. And then these here. And heck yeah, we have some stuff. All right, let me empty this crap in here. I think I have stackables, right? We have things that stack here. I can scrap that and then it'll stack. I don't really need to carry this. And you can go in there. Can that stack in there? I don't think it could, but whatever. I just want to get all this crap emptied out of here. Let's go empty these over in the other chest, though. In our working chest, where we shall be working. And I need to empty that in there. I hope I can make another hammer. I don't know, though. Ugh. Oh my goodness, guys. It's going to be an horrible night. And that needs upgraded. Alright, yeah, maybe we could do Horde Night. We might just do Horde Night on Saturday, too. It's very doable. I just don't have a lot of arrows, so I hope we don't have a lot of zombies. Because I don't have a lot of arrows, and I don't really have time to go out looking for any feathers. I don't, really. We're going to go empty this crap over here, and then I'm going to cut the video. Because I want to be able to bring you guys back for Horde Night, either during the stream, or it will be in the next video. We shall see, which would be Monday. Monday. Alright, let's put these in here. I don't need to carry all this stuff with me either. I'll put that in there. Maybe put half of this in here or something. Put the wrench in here. Put that in there. Not gonna need my shovel. Not gonna need that or that. I do feel like maybe... Oh, I want to take that, though. What else is in here? What else? I don't see any reason to bring this stuff with me. Hopefully I don't regret bringing that with me. We're gonna take these over there. My girl is like really low on food. That could be horrible for us too. I don't really need the barbed wire. We just need this stuff. Gonna need that. I don't really need the bone shiv. I should go hunting for food. Hopefully I'm gonna be alright until Horde Night's over. I don't know. That could be super bad. I could keel over from starvation or something. That could be a thing that happens for real. I'm gonna keep my bone shiv with me. Oh, we can leave this because we're not doing anything with cobblestone. Alright, guys. So, yeah. I guess I'm gonna go down below. Let's make sure we don't have anything down below we might need for Horde Night, too. Don't worry, I'm gonna be finished with all this stuff and over there and ready for Horde Night. Well, as ready as I can be. I don't have any freaking food, though. That might be an issue for real. For real, Lucille. Maybe I'm gonna set up some gas barrels to blow up. That could help a little bit, right? Of course, it'll blow up my shit, too, which isn't totally cool. I don't think I have anything in here. I did set up this stuff in here, guys. I don't know if you knew I did that or not. But yes, I'm gradually moving things over. Oh, I have some food. Awesome. I'll take that and probably eat that while we're over there. Maybe take a couple jars of honey in case someone gets up there and infects me. Any food in here? Of course not. Why would I have food? Why would I have any food anywhere? We'll take some water over there. Alright, guys. We're gonna go back over there. I think that's all we have. I'm pretty sure I don't have anything else. And then we will call the video there. And yes, we have airdrops. We'll go for them, you know, hopefully in a video next week. We're gonna take our mini bike over there. I'm just gonna keep it where it will be safe from all the silliness that's gonna go down on Horde Night. Yup. And I'm sorry if I seem down today, guys. You're, just be glad I'm not putting up the video that I was actually sobbing in. I couldn't hardly speak. I was so upset. It's so horrible. Alright, so we're here. We're about ready for our amazing Horde Night. Or not amazing Horde Night, whatever you want to call it. Let's take these down. Don't want to leave any way for them to get up here. Put that block there. I don't think they can get up here. Wait a minute. Oh. Oh no, they can't get up here the way I set that up. Alright guys, so we're going to end it there. Thanks for being here. Thanks for listening to me sob and be all down in the dumps and all that good stuff. Just know that's not going to happen very often. I really think the stream the other night just really set things in motion for that. So I think that's why I kind of had a little bit of a breakdown, maybe. Maybe just a little. Let's put these weapons on here that we know we'll be using. Oh no, we're not using that nasty ass pistol. That's a piece of shit. That's the good one we want. And then these. I think. Does this use that or does it use this? I don't remember. But that's all we got anyway. Alright, let me put this crap in here. Where should I put these barrels at? That is the question. Let's put that in there. I'll put the yucca in there. I don't need to carry it. I'm going to have the beer on me just in case. We don't really need all these waters on us. I am going to drink as much of that as I can, though. Drink. Actually, let me eat this first because this is going to dry out my mouth. I'm going to eat all these. And then I will drink as much water and yucca as I can. And then we should be ready for our Horde Night. Ready? Ready for our Horde Night. Come on, bring that health back up to 122. Do it. Yeah, I still got to record a subsistence video for tomorrow, so we got to get this one done. We got to get her done. I would have already had the subsistence one done if I had not been upset earlier. Alright, let's drink one of these because it will bring up our health as well. And then we're gonna drink some water. Yeah, maybe one more of those, just for the heck of it. And now everything should be up to where it needs to be. Put these things in here, put the jars in there, put the hammer in there. I meant to leave the hammer over there. Totally forgot. Put that in there. I'm gonna make another bow. Let's make another bow before we go. Another bow. Crafty craft craft. I'm just gonna scrap that one. Scrappy dough. That one on there. Alright, so we're ready for Horde Night. Alright, I'll bring y'all back for Horde Night either during the live stream on Saturday or it'll be in a recording on Monday. Alright guys, so until next time, I will catch you later. Bye!